Welcome to our Friday class. Last week we discussed all the modern day prophets of our church up until our present day situation without a prophet. We explained some of the reasons why we could no longer follow what the church was preaching and had to break off and go back to what Joseph Smith Jr. had established in 1830.
Hello, 欢迎来到礼拜五的课程。上星期我们谈到我们教会所有近代先知们，直到现今没有先知的情况。我们也说明了一些理由，有关为什么我们无法再追随教会的教导，且必须分开回到1830年约瑟·史密斯第二代所创办的。
This week, we are going to discuss the organization of our church today. We will talk about the different priesthood positions and what we foresee as the future of our church. Let's get started.
这星期我们将谈到现今我们教会的组织性，还有我们将谈到有关不同神职人员的职位和我们沾观我们教会的未来。让我们现在开始吧。
When our church is fully organized, we have 10 different priesthood positions. They fall into two categories, the Aaronic priesthood and the Melchizedek priesthood. Let's focus on the Aaronic priesthood first. There are three offices in this priesthood, teacher, deacon, and priest. Their job is focused more on the physical aspects of the church and in the families.
当我们完成了组织性，我们会有十种不同的神职职位，他们会分为两派系，有亚伦神职亚伦神职制和麦基洗德制。让我们先专注在亚伦神职制，这种神职派系会有三个职位，有教师、执事和祭司。他们的工作是比较专注在教会的硬体、外观及家庭方面。
First, let's talk about the deacons of the church. The deacons need to prepare the church for worship. They unlock the doors, they turn on the lights, turn on the sound system. They make sure the hymnals are set up.
And that the speaker of the hour has a glass of water. They also set the air conditioners and heaters, depending on the time of year.
It is their job to make sure that everything is ready for us to have church.
让我们先谈教会的教会执事。执事们必须为教会崇拜做准备。他们为教会开门、开灯，还有开音响系统。他们要确定教会诗本有没有放置好。还有为正道人准备水喝，查看季节所需用的冷暖气，这是他们的职责，确定为我们准备好教会。
When people start to come, many deacons greet people at the door. They will hand out bulletins so everyone knows what's going on during the service.Very soon, David will be ordained to the office of deacon.
当人们开始来教会，许多的执事会在教会门口问候人们。玛尼卡说，就拿她的祖母做例子，她将车子一开到教会后，将钥匙丢给执事，那执事们就会为她把车子开到停车场去，那她就不需要走很远的路。这些执事们呢，会发出崇拜的布告单给每一个人，好让每一个人知道崇拜时要做些什么。还有崇拜时，他们会去收集一些奉献金，这些只是一些执事的一些职责而已。
Next, we'll talk about the teachers. The teacher's job is to watch that there is no backbiting or bad things going on in the church. They watch with the everyone gets along with everyone else. If not, then they will work with the elders to meet with those who are fighting to try and resolve the issue. They make sure that all members are fulfilling their responsibilities and being kind one to another.
下一个我们要谈到教师。教师的工作是看管教会里有没有闲言闲语，或是有坏的事情正在教会传言。他们看管每一个人有没有与人相处和好，如果没有，他们会会与长老一起与那些吵架者协谈，或是帮忙解决之间的问题。他们必须确定教会的教友有没有完成他们的职责，做好他们的职责，有没有人与和平相处。
Now let's talk about the third and final office of the Aaronic priesthood, the priest. The priest is different from the other two Aaronic priesthood members because the priest can baptize, but only the baptism of the water, not the laying on of hands.The priest can also serve the sacrament, which the teachers and deacons cannot do.
现在让我们来谈有关第三个执事，也是最后一个执事，就是亚伦神职员所说的祭司。这个祭司与前面两位亚伦神职员执事是不同的，因为这个祭司可以帮人施洗，但是只施浸水礼，而不是按手礼。祭司可以传送圣餐，这个是教师和执事所不能做的。
One of the jobs of the priest is to go into homes. They meet the families and teach them how to pray together aloud and in private. They help the families with any problems, and they are there to support the families however they need help. We want our families.To be strong and faithful, and it is important that the families worship together and study and pray together to help them stay focused on God's will for their families.
祭司最重要的职责是拜访家庭，他们去教友家庭拜访，教导他们大家一起大声祷告和饮食祷告。他们帮忙解决家庭问题，及支持家庭去帮助需要被帮助的家庭。我们要我们的家人强壮及有信心， 家人一起崇拜，一起研读圣经，一起祷告，那是很重要的。他们帮忙，他们为家人专注在上帝的旨意里。
So those are the three offices of the Aaronic priesthood: deacon, teacher, and priest. Now we will move on to the Melchizedek priesthood, which focuses more on the spiritual side of our church. There are seven offices within the Melchizedek priesthood: elder, 70, bishop, patriarch evangelist, high priest, apostle, and prophet. Let's learn a little about each one.
所以亚伦有三种神职职位，有执事、祭司，还有教师。现在我们将转移到麦基洗德制，这种制度比较专注在我们教会的灵命方面，有七种职位。麦基洗德制有长老、最高祭司、70人、财务管理、长老传道、使徒和先知。让我们来学习一点点有关这些每一位的执事职位。
The first office of the Melchizedek priesthood that we'll talk about is elder. There are many elders in our church. Usually the pastor of the church is an elder. The elders focus on the spiritual needs of the branch. They can baptize both of water and the spirit, and administer the sacrament and perform all the ordinances, such as marrying people, bless babies, administer to those who are sick, and ordain people to elder, priest, teacher, or deacon. They cannot ordain people to higher positions.
第一个职事我们将要谈到有关的是长老。我们教会里有很多位长老，通常教会的主持人是一位长老。长老专注在给予教会的灵命，他们可以帮人受洗，这个受洗包括了净水施洗礼，还有圣灵的见证礼。他们给予圣餐仪式，履行任命仪式，就像证婚、婴孩祝福、给病者医病，还有任命人成为长老或祭司、教师或执事。他们并不可以任命人有更高的职位。
All of the offices of both priesthoods can preach the gospel. The elders need to make sure that the worship services and activities of the branch are led by the Holy Spirit. The elder has been given the power by God to lay on hands on a person's head for healings and blessings. Many people who are ordained to higher offices first came into the Melchizedek priesthood as an elder. Jared Smith, Monica's dad, and Def Doherty are all examples of elders.
这两种神职派系的不同，两者都可以传道。长老必须确定教会的崇拜及教会活动是在圣灵的引导之下。长老在上帝给予力量后，按手在人的头上，给予做医治祷告或是祝福祷告。许多人谁被任命为最高祭司之前，必须先任命为麦基洗德制的长老职位。就像 Jerry Smith， 还有 Monica 的爸爸，还有 Duff， 他们就是被任命为长老，这是一个例子。
The next office is the 70. This person is a missionary for the church. They are often sent out by the apostles to go places all over the world to preach the gospel. They spent a lot of their time in services to God in other countries. They get to meet people from all over, and they get to eat some strange foods. And they often get to learn new languages to communicate with those they meet. One example of the A70 is Steve DeVera, whom Patricia stayed with in America before she was married.
下一个执事是七十人，这人是教会的传道人，通常被使徒差派去世界各地传福音。他们花了他们一生很多的时间在其他国家侍奉上帝。他们会晤许多世界其他各地的人，他们也得以尝试许多不同的食物。通常他们也学会当地的语言，得以跟他们沟通。有一个例子，七十人就是 Steve Devera， 就是当初 Patricia 在结婚之前住在他家里。
Now let's move on to talking about the bishop. The bishop is in charge of the financial side of the church. They deal with money. Every year, people are supposed to give tithe money to the church as an offering or sacrifice. The bishop watches over the money coming in. Also, the people are called to build a storehouse.Where people give food, blankets, clothes, or extra items they have to go into a building. People who are in need can come to the building, and the bishop will distribute the items to those in need according to the number of people in their family. We're still working on this because right now we don't have a bishop in our church.The pastors of the branches are having to cover for this part.
让我们转移到财务管理。财务管理是管理教会的财务方面的执事，他们管理金钱。每年人们应该奉献11奉献给教会，或视为一般的奉献。财务管理金钱的收入。也有一些被呼召去建造一个储藏室，储藏食物，像是还有储藏毯子、衣服或是其他的项额，准备给予人们用。当人们有所需求时，可以来到这个储藏室，这个财务管理就可以奉献出不同的需求给不同的人们，甚至包括了需求者的家人。我们教会现在还在试着建造这一项执事，因为我们教会现在还没有财务管理。一般教会的管理人或是主持人，他们正在做这项工作。
The fourth office is the evangelist patriarch. These men are like fathers to the church. They offer guidance to the church.And to individuals during their patriarchal blessing. We do not have many evangelist patriarchs left in the church, maybe two or three.
This is the 第四个执事，也就是长老传道。这些人也就像是教会的父亲，他们给予教会引导。和个人的长老祝福。玛丽卡的曾祖父就是一个 长老传道，他的名字是 Paul Fisher， 是一位长老传道。我们教会并没有很多的长老传道，目前也许只有两位到三位而已。
The high priests of the church are like elders, but they participate in higher offices of the church. They can help the prophet. We do not have any high priest in our church now.
是教会的最高祭司，就像长老一样，他们参与教会的比较高的职事，他们可以帮助先知。 现在我们教会没有这个最高祭司。
Next, we have apostles. When the church is organized, there should be 12 apostles that can help make decisions with the prophet. The apostles are in charge of sending the 70s out. The apostles might travel to check up on the churches and missions.
当我们教会组织完成以后，我们就会有使徒，应该会有12个使徒。他们帮助先知做决定，使徒掌管差派70人。使徒们他们也许需要去教会分费，去检视教会，还有检视教会的任务。
Our last office of the Melchizedek priesthood is the prophet. We've talked about our church's prophet.In our last classes, prophets like Joseph Smith Jr., Joseph Smith III, Frederick M. Smith, Israel A. Smith, W. Wallace, and Wallace B. Smith.
我们的最后一位执事，麦基喜德执事就是先知。在前几堂课里边，我们已经讨论过有关我们教会的先知。就像是约瑟·史密斯第二代，还有约瑟·史密斯第三代，还有 Frederick M. Smith， 还有Israel A. Smith， 还有 W. Wallace Smith， 还有 Wallace B. Smith。
The prophet leads the church. God often speaks through the prophet.To bring new revelations to the church to help us know what we need to bring for sign. Right now, our church doesn't have a prophet, but that's okay. We're waiting for Jesus Christ to return. He will be our prophet and put his church in order.
先知领导教会，上帝通常会透过先知带领给教会新的启示，帮助我们知道我们应该做些什么带来锡安世界。目前我们教会并没有先知，但这是还好，我们现在正在等待耶稣再度回到这世上，他将会是我们的先知，且重整他的教会。
At this time, our church can only ordain new elders, priests, teachers, and deacons. We would need a prophet for God to call anyone to any of the other offices. Our church doesn't believe in men deciding that they want to be in the priesthood. All of the men, and our church only has men in the priesthood, are called by God to these offices, depending on their faith, their humility, and their obedience to God's commandments.
在这个时候，我们教会只可以任命新的长老、新的祭司、新的教师、新的执事。我们需要一位先知为上帝呼召其他的执事，但我们的教会并不相信人们自己可以做决定要成为一位神职人员。我们的教会只有男人在神职人员里，没有女人。所有的人都被呼召。所有的人是透过上帝被呼召成为执事的，是依靠他们的信心，还有他们的谦卑得来的，还有他们的顺服，以还有顺服上帝，还有上帝的契约。
Now you know a little bit about the organization of our church and the different offices of the priesthood. Let's close our class by singing "Make Me a Servant."
现在你们知道一点点有关我们教会的组织性及不同神职人员的职位。现在让我们来唱一首 Make Me a Servant 来结束这个课程。